Wisconsin Manufacturers and Commerce, you know, WMC, which is like the Chamber of Commerce for the state of Wisconsin. They represent businesses, so they have, you know, they have their different, I mean, they've got their viewpoint. But they did a survey of Wisconsin employers, and they asked a couple questions moving forward, because it's the idea is, okay, we're gonna spend more money on school kids. Okay, is that going to make a difference? So here's the new survey, and I'm just looking at some of the top lines of this. According to their employer survey, nearly three quarters of businesses in Wisconsin think students graduating from public K-12 system schools are not prepared for the workforce. Nearly three quarters, 73%. They asked the question, do you believe that students graduating from Wisconsin's public K-12 system are prepared for the workforce? Yes, 27%. No, 73%. They asked, do you have employees who struggle with the ability to read or do math? 56% say yes, 44% say no. Do you ever have to provide employees with additional education or tutoring because their K-12 education did not prepare them with the basic skills needed for a career? Over 40% say yes. Have you reduced your hiring requirements? For example, the amount of experience needed, the level of educational attainment, etc., in an effort to get more job applicants. So have you dumbed down the job requirements? 63% say yes. And the numbers kind of go on and on, but it paints this portrait of a work, at least from the perspective of employers who are looking at the field of potential candidates who are coming in. And, you know, it paints, you know, a pretty unflattering, you know, picture. 73% of people getting out of high school in Wisconsin, you know, the employers at least say they're not prepared for the workforce. 56% of employees who are struggling with the ability to read or do math. And our answer right now is, okay, well, we're going to throw some money at it. We'll put another $2,000 into student spending or whatever. Our number is 855-616-1620, which is the old National Bank talk and text line. I'm sorry. I just don't think that is the answer. Is spending money, increasing per pupil spending in public school education, let's say we're going to spend another $1,000, we're going to spend another $2,000, we're going to spend another $5,000 per pupil. Is that going to make a fundamental difference? Will the kids be coming out of school more prepared than they are now? Will the kids be coming out of school with more abilities to do basic math or reading? Or is this money that is just going to be essentially just thrown away? Does money make a difference? And will money make a difference? And you have these employers that are coming out and they're asking these employers a question. Hey, okay, the folks who are graduating from high school, can they read? Can they write? Do they need remedial help? And the numbers are staggering. Yes, they do. Are they prepared for the workforce? Well, almost three quarters of employers say no, that the people we're seeing aren't. And even if you color this a little bit and say, okay, well, maybe the employers always have unreasonable expectations, seems to me this should be just a real warning. There should be warning lights going off saying we're not doing what we need to do, which is teaching kids how to read and how to write and preparing them for skills. And I guess I wrestle with this whole idea of, you know, we always hear, okay, well, they need more money. We need more money. We need more money. Okay, well, all right, you're going to get more money under this latest budget. Is $2,000 more going to make a difference? Jeff, I work in a middle school, and I already see kids who are completely disinterested in education. I think rather than just throwing money into an already dysfunctional system, we need to start rethinking education. Maybe we need to set schools up for certain kids early on that get them prepared to do a job. Obviously, the basic fundamentals need to continue. However, there's no sense in teaching someone math beyond the basic needs of budgeting a household for certain people. I think that that's an answer. Jeff, the school systems want more money, but when asked for a plan for that money, the answer often seems to be none of your business. I worked in a supervisory position for a manufacturing company. I actually developed a system for teaching people how to read a ruler because so few could. I also had a problem for teaching a system for teaching fractions and decibels. Jeff, will increasing funds for each student will not make a difference. What we need is to get back to basics: reading, writing, and arithmetic. I've worked with interns and new hires, and all, not most, all lack very basic skills. Basic math, communication, etc. They can all work a computer, but we always have to retrain them. Well, I think you've got something there. 855-616-1620. And again, I want to see, from my perspective, it's not, oh, we shouldn't spend the money on education or things like that. But I think we've gotten to this point where there's this idea that, okay, money is the solution to everything. And I just don't believe that that's true. And if you've got somebody, some kid, and it's $15,000 a year that we're spending, all right, and that kid is coming out of high school reading at a sixth grade level, all right, if we up that per pupil spending to $17,000, is that going to change it? And my answer would be, I don't think so.